Do you want to go ice fishing? Yeah. Do you want to watch Bob on the way there?
Oh, go rush.
Okay.
Go rush.
Alright, let's get some more bait.
Run. Run.
Oh, look at them all. Shiners, smelts, cows if you need them. Alright, you ready to get some shiners?
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, let's scoop some of these shiners out. We already got our smelts. Here, we got a good bunch on that one. We'll dip them in here and then count them out.
And then we go.
Look at those ones that we got. Look at them all. Yeah, there's some in there, huh? Those are suckers. We don't need those ones. We're gonna get these ones. So now let's pay. It's $10 a dozen for smelts and $5 a dozen for shiners.
Tomorrow's a new day for everyone. A brand new moon, brand new sun.
Oh, we made it to camp. It's gonna be our base of operations for Caribou Lake. The locals are already entertaining themselves. What are you doing over there? All right, now we're just getting ready for tomorrow. We're gonna leave real early. I know we're gonna park up at Caribou, so we need to swap a couple things around in here. Gonna be driving out the back, not the front, on the Golden Road. So I'm gonna pull this machine out, swap some things around. We got the bait on aerators over there. Separated the shiners from the smelts, because sometimes the shiners can knock the smelts around and beat them up. That's the aerator. Whoa, it's easy. What's that? Oh, that's Grampy's heater. Can you hear it up there?
Yeah.
Yep. There it is. It's keeping his four-wheeler warm in there. All right, we're gonna keep moving on with the ice fishing stuff. You want help? Yeah, it's too icy. Why don't you come over here and I'll hold your hand.
Icy.
Yep, be careful. It's real icy, right? Whoa. I'll probably be the one that falls.
We gotta
put Heidi's seat on too. Rig. Merritt and I made Heidi a box last fall. Clips right onto the existing frame. We took a frame from this system and built it right into the box so she can ride with us. Takes up a little bit of the deck space, but it's better than making her run the whole way. Right?
So follow, follow the sun, the direction of the birds, the direction of love. Cherish this moment, cherish this breath. Tomorrow's a new day for everyone.
Brand new moon. There, what do you think? You ready?
Yeah.
All right, we're all loaded up. Head onto the lake right there. Caribou Lake. Wow, look at that big mountain over there. Oh, there it is. Look at that. We got another flag up. Look at that. We caught our first salmon. Yep. This is crazy out here. I'm trying to get 10 traps in and we can't keep up with the flags. We just pulled a nice salmon out of this hole. Hey, guess what? Mare, look at Dad. We have a flag over there. Do you see it? There it is. Let's go see what's going on. Stop it. Look at that, it's going. All right, we're gonna let this run for a minute. The salmon will bite and they grab onto the head of the bait and then they run. And if you pull the trap up right away, then usually you end up pulling the bait right out of their mouth because they haven't got to the hook yet. See. All right, let's go see if we got a fish on. You want help? Okay, I'll help you. It is icy, isn't it? Whoa. still going. All right, it's been out for a little while. We got quite a bit of line out. Let's see if he's hooked. Feels like we got him. You excited to see what it is? Mm-hmm. Hopefully it's not a perch. Oh, look at that. Nice salmon. Wow. Wow. Let's rinse them off a little bit. Wow. That's a perfect size one. Look at that. Look at that. What do you think? Look at them. It's a perfect size. Okay. We got them, huh? All right, let's get the hook out and then we'll dispatch them. Watch out for the line. Okay, Daddy's gotta go grab his tools off his jacket because it's so nice and warm out here. Not wearing a jacket. And for tools, we have forceps to pull out the hook and a knife to bleed the fish. Okay, first thing, we'll bleed the fish. Now we gotta get the hook out. We waited just the right amount of time. That's okay, I'll take care of dispatching them. We'll give them a little bop after. Hold on. I will take care of that part just a second. Let me get the hook out. There it is. Okay, let's attach that to the pants. We already bled him. Now let's give him a little bop and knock him out. Watch out, watch your foot. Give him a little bop. Second little bop. And I think that's it. Yep. All right, let's clean this trap up and we'll get it rebaited. We'll bring our fish back to camp. There, really nice salmon. Perfect size, about 12 inches. Took out a fair amount of line, but like I said, you gotta let them run a little bit. All right, here we go again. Still running pretty good. Thank you. Can I have a sip? So we're gonna wait for him to stop, which it looks like he just did. There he's stopping. Usually when they're stopping, they're eating, and then they'll start taking off again. So take a little bit of a break. And we got a little bit more movement. All right. Let's see what we got on this one. Feels small. I'm gonna keep tension on the line, just in case it is hooked just on barely on the lip. A little bit of fight there. Oh, look at that. Another nice salmon. Another good 12 incher. These ones are perfect. Cook up two of these. For a two-person meal with some rice and spinach, and you're in good shape. Perfect. You know, we're trying to reduce our dependency on the grocery store and all kinds of unhealthy meats. Right now we produce our own cattle. We produce our own chickens and fish. We've had good luck going out haddock fishing with my nephew. So we've got a bunch of haddock in the freezer. But the only thing that we buy is salmon at the grocery store. Really like blackened salmon. So we're trying to close that loop. A little tension on that line so I can see the hook. Oops. Keeps getting caught on the way out. There we go. All right. Away from the hole. All right, we'll give this guy a little bop. Bop. And a little rinse. Geez, I don't know if that bop worked. There. I don't want him suffering. Bad enough getting pulled up by a hook. All right, let's rinse him off a little bit. Clean him up nice. There. We've got some blood around this hole. This seems to be a good spot. We've got 8 traps out. So we'll probably maybe cut another one near this one. Beautiful day out here, warm enough that I can use my hands without gloves on. How are those chips?
Yeah.
Good? Nice. There we go. All right, we're using a combination of smelts and shiners. I wasn't sure how the smelts would do on the ride up here. It's a little bit bumpy, so I got a bunch of shiners just in case. They're usually pretty hardy. Here's how I'm hooking them. So that hook is facing right towards the front where the fish is gonna hit it. And then when they eat it and you pull, instead of that hook being in the wrong direction and just popping out, it catches them right on the side of the mouth or just down in the mouth. It's perfect. All right, he's just under the ice. Prep this line. Always try to drop the line in one area without tangling it as it comes out, because that just makes for a nightmare. It's not so bad when it's real cold out and the line freezes because it's less apt to tangle. But when it's warm like this, you want to prep the line. That way when you're re-reeling your reel, it won't tangle. We've got a lot of action out here, so we don't want to spend time untangling line. Oops. Back reel there. All right, we'll go drop that salmon off, and then we'll set another trap probably right around here. We'll get 10 in. Merritt's got his lifetime fishing license. His grandparents for Christmas, that was really cool. So when he's done eating, we'll get him pulling some traps. Do you love ice fishing?
No.
No? Do you like the snowmobile? No. Yeah. Do you like fishing?
No.
No? Do you like fish? Sometimes. got another flag.
It's 10 or 12.
Reel was spinning really good when I showed up. Then it stopped. So we took the bait, and now we're gonna give it a pull and see if we got something. Oh, that's a good one. Oh, geez. Oh, wow. What the heck is that? Oh my God. That is a heavy fish. Wow. Oh my God. Jeez. He's pulling the line back out of my hands. Oh my goodness. Look at that one. Wow. All right. Let's check the length real quick. That one is just under 16. Perfect. Really nice fish. My thumbs are gonna be all messed up by the end of this day. Oh, he got me good. A little bit of a racer, not too fat like the other 15 incher we caught. Sure gonna taste good in a pan though. Let's see if we can't get him to open his mouth again here. There we go. Get a thumb in there. Use the other fingers to keep pressure on the line. That way we can see where the hook is. Oh, there's my bait. There it is. The bait is still hooked. Look at that. Just a little shiner. We hooked that one perfect. All right, well, we'll unhook that shiner. Get a new bait on there. Took out a little less line than I thought. Yeah, that reel was calling when I got here. They don't seem to be picky between shiners or smelts. Smelts have a tendency to swim in circles down there, get the line all tangled up. And the shiners don't do that, which is kind of nice. There, get in the water. The shiner is also real good about swimming down under the ice. And the smelt's not so much. There he goes. Get this one back in the game. I was just over there getting ready to clean up the fish that we already have. That way when we get back to camp tonight, we don't have a big pile of work to do. So we'll get them as many as we can taken care of out here. We'll leave the mess right on the ice for the eagles. Give them a little snack. Or the coyotes, or whatever comes out here. Something will. Leader's right there. A couple feet. And a couple more. There we go. 3, 4, 2 feet. Nah. Somewhere in there. Doesn't really matter. As long as it's not on bottom. one set. And it looks like the wolves are already waiting. Oh, we got another flag. Merritt took a nice 2-hour nap. It was pretty quiet in that time. Heidi, come here. Come here, Heidi. And we have a visitor out there. Probably waiting for us to move on out. All right. This one was turning pretty good a minute ago. Looks like he's probably eating now. We'll give it a pull and see what happens. All right.
Oh, mommy.
It hasn't moved in a little bit. Oh, we got him. Feels like a pretty good one. Here it comes. Oh, look at that!
Again.
Wow!
Baby.
That's a nice one, huh?
Again. Again. Baby.
Yeah, it's a little one. Perfect size for us. That's what we're looking for. Bop and pop that hook out. There.
That's a pinky.
That's a nice fish, huh? That one, huh?
A nice.
Yeah, it's a nice one.
A nice.
There. Okay. We'll get a bait. Get this one back in action. There it is. Didn't run too far. Oh geez, we got another flag right there in front of our campsite. Just popped up. Oh, and Heidi's tangled. Come here, Heidi. There you go. Jeepers creepers, Merritt. You woke up and all the fish started biting again. You must be the lucky charm here. A baby?
Mm.
Yeah, it's a nice little one. It's perfect size for a pan. We're gonna put that in a stainless steel pan and season it with a little bit of Cajun seasoning and bed that thing right on some rice.
I got rice. Mommy, rice.
And you like rice too, right? Yep, we'll put it on some rice if that's what you're saying, I think. Wow. You gotta quit smoking. Mm. Okay, that one's back in action. Let's grab our fish and we'll go see what's on the other trap over there. Jeepers creepers. Look at that. Got a little campsite set up there. Wind kicked up just a hair. And we've got a flag right next to it. Well, just as I said that, with the campsite over there, we've got another flag right there. The afternoon bite is starting. All right, in the time it took us to get to this flag, we already had that one up down there on the end, and the other flag on the other end popped up down there. So we're gonna see if we can't get these pulled up pretty quick, that way we don't get spooled. Nothing worse than having to do a whole reel of line. All right, we've been after this fish for about 10 minutes. It stole a couple bait. I think because we had like four flags up at once and I pulled it too quick. Then I put a new bait right back down and it picked that one off. So we're letting it run this time. Got a little fired up with all the flags going off. But we had about an hour's worth of time where it was pretty quiet. Then Merritt woke up and boom. Flag crazy around here. All right, he stopped. Let's see what's going on. I don't know. I think it's a little one because the bait keeps pulling out. Well, let's reel it up and check it. Nope, nothing on this one. Must be a real little fish. Whoops. Yeah, it's a little one because he hit our bait, ran with it for quite a ways, but didn't swallow it, so it must be a real little one. That's all right. If he hits us again and doesn't take the bait, then we'll put a real small... small bait on there. Oh boy, I didn't take my own advice. Prep the line. Too busy chatting. There we go. Jeez, he's back again. What the heck is that? Let's bring it up real slow. See if we can see what it is down there that's attacking our bait. Oh, that's a good sized salmon. He's right there. All right, well, our bait's still alive. Send him back down.
Up, up.
There he goes again. Look at that. All right, so what we're gonna do is we're just gonna set that in there and let him munch on it a while. The reel's turning. We don't have any other flags, so no rush. We gotta get this fish because he's cleaning us out of bait. It must be that one salmon that hits the bait from the back end. He doesn't run like a salmon, though. I saw a little bit of it. Looked like a salmon to me. But we'll just chill out and let him eat. Ugh. Real slow and steady. Salmon usually jerk the reel and backlash it a little bit. Do you like this snowmobile?
Nah.
Yeah. So anyways, this is the Skidoo Expedition Super Wide Track. It's got a 24-inch track on it. And we've got a winch on the front. That thing came in like 10,000 pieces. Merritt and I put it together. Always keep a shovel, just in case you do get stuck. We've had to use it a couple times this year. Had to use the winch yesterday. We went down a small little hill that was real icy and couldn't get back up it. We got the modified dog box. Chainsaw, absolutely essential. Because usually we're building a campfire on shore, but here we're fishing kind of in the middle, which isn't normal for me, but it works out here. And then the old otter sled. It's been a great machine. I've had it for 2 years. I've got a whopping 500 miles on it. So I think this year we'll probably do a service, have them go through it. Because we go on some long treks into the middle of nowhere, like Lobster Lake. And we can't have anything being funky on us when you're going that far out. I do keep a Garmin inReach. Get that mounted right up there. And we do have the inReach subscription, so we can text with mom at home all the time, whatever. And that way, if we have any issue, we can slam that SOS button. But mostly just have it for texting home, which is really nice. We've got another 1 year old at home. We've got a farm, the whole nine yards. So it's nice to keep in contact. And we're not usually fishing in places where there's cell phone service, so you gotta have it. Costs $50 a month for the expedition plan, which is unlimited messaging and all that stuff. So, money well spent. One incident, and it absolutely pays for itself. And, because Mummy's happy, that lets us get out. All right, let's see what this thing's doing, huh? We let it eat long enough. It's kind of slowed down. Must have circled back because I don't feel anything. Either that or it stole the bait, I don't know what's going on with this fish. We're going to have to put a little tiny baby smelt on it. Yep, we're going to swap this bait out and we're going to put a little smelt on it. He's not interested in the shiner, I guess. I've got some little smelts in here. That's a real little one. We're going to have to be careful hooking this guy. One slip and it's going to go too deep. Perfect. All right. Don't swim back up. There he goes under the ice. Perfect. Okay, we are 0-for-3 on this salmon, but we're gonna get him. Right, Heidi? Heidi, you ready for your grilled cheese sandwich?
No.
No, Heidi doesn't get one? She can have some bites of mine. I brought enough for her, though. Okay. There's the leader. Boom. Well, at least he didn't get that last bait on us, and he didn't hurt it. Those shiners are pretty tough, so back in the bucket he goes. We'll use him on another hole. Well, we were gonna go make our grilled cheese, but as soon as we got there, we ended up with a flag. So, back we came. Different flag than the one over there that keeps stealing our stuff. Okay, this one was running when we got here. Oh, he seems to have stopped, so we'll wait till he moves again and then we'll pull it. There it goes. Let's hope for a big one. That's pretty good. Maybe a nice... Oh, popped out. Must have been a little one.
Not big.
No.
A big.
Look at that. Stole the bait. She just barely had a hold of it. Well, that happens.
No. Oops.
All right, that shiner that other fish was after, we'll put him in this hole. He's doing pretty good.
Papa, Dada.
nice to get a break to have some lunch, huh?
No! No!
I was kind of looking for the grilled cheese. Glad we don't have to eat hot dogs. Be careful. Another flag. My goodness, we're gonna starve to death.
Right there. All right. Well, we gotta go get another flag. Got a really nice grilled cheese going. Just getting ready to sit down for lunch. Oh, another flag. Wow, the lunchtime flag really paid off. Look at that one. That's a nice one. Wow. That's gonna be our 1/16 inches, I think. Let's measure them. See how big he is. 17 inches. 18 inches, no kidding. All right, we're gonna keep that guy. That's a nice one. There, we just caught a lot of fish all at once, right? Sun popped out a little bit. Now we, bless you. We've got another flag. Right over there. So we'll go after that one next.
You ready? Geez, it's the first time we don't have any of the flags up. Like we got something. Oh, it's the first perch of the day. Look, we caught a perch.
A baby.
It's the first one we've seen all day. My goodness. Sound the alarm.
It's a little one. That one will leave for the eagles. You ready? This is it. It's 4:15. We got here at 8. put in a great day. Got all of our fish cleaned. When we had a couple of minutes, we did. Did you have fun? Yeah, I did too. All right, we'll put our fish in the cooler and head home. Great day. Hopefully we don't get any more flags because I'm exhausted. Cherish this moment, cherish this breath. Tomorrow's a new day for everyone. A brand new moon.